I'm here with my friends Jenna, Dewan, and Steve Kazee, and you guys were at WrestleMania Night 1. We are back for WrestleMania Night 2. What are you guys looking forward to, and what did you enjoy the most about last night?
Ooh, I mean, I loved it all. This is still really new for me because I was sort of brought into this world through Steve, and now I'm fully here. I mean, literally, I'm wearing the shirts. I'm fully here in this world. I loved it. I had so much fun. It was a blast. I mean, we talked about the entrances. I love the drama and all the pyro and the lights. It was so, it's larger than life. It's amazing.
I mean, I don't know how you choose what like the best moment of last night was. I was telling her, like, it's hard to know how much better it could get, because last night was one of the best manias, I thought, of all time. And the fact that you have two nights in a row, I just don't know how to process it right now. But definitely, like, Sammy and Kevin finally getting it done, getting those belts off the Usos. Charlotte and Rhea was amazing. It was just like Seth and Logan was actually really good. It was just hard to like pick a favorite match last night. We talked about it forever. It was just such a great night.
Yeah, it was really good. It was really fun.
Well, I see you're rocking the DX shirt today. You had, oh, there we go.
Oh,
there we go.
See, I'm learning. I'm still learning.
Yes.
You were rocking the Stacey Keibler shirt yesterday in support of your friend who is now an inductee into the WWE Hall of Fame.
She's a Hall of Famer. Stacey's been my friend since we were 8. We danced against each other, actually, in Baltimore. And then we've stayed friends forever. And I've been friends with, I know wrestling Stacey. I know Stacey outside of wrestling. But for her to have that full circle moment and for us to be able to be there was really, really amazing.
Awesome.
She's such a wonderful human being. Like, she's such a good friend.
I mean, we talked about this yesterday a little bit. Steve geeked out when he found out that you were friends with Stacey.
Yes, sure. We did. It was like, you should know I love wrestling. I love the WWE. I was like, oh my gosh, one of my best friends was a wrestler. He's like, wait, hold on a second. Stacey Keibler is one of your best friends? I was like, yeah, I grew up with her. Like, no big deal. Clearly a big deal for you.
Very, very big deal for me.
You had a crush on her, right?
Well, yeah, of course. Didn't everybody, like literally every...
I have a crush on her.
World. Yeah. Who said it the other night about when Stacey was on TV, no one changed the channel. Mick said that during the speech. It was just like, that's the very true thing. Like, she changed television watching in that era in such an incredible way.
She's like that, though, even in person. Yeah. A conversation, a party. You just don't take your eyes off her. She's statuesque and she's magical and all this. So I was really happy for her. That was awesome.
Well, I love that you have become a diehard WWE fan now. You guys doing SmackDown, WWE Hall of Fame, WrestleMania Night 1, WrestleMania Night 2, and you're coming back tomorrow for Monday Night Raw.
That's
so
right.
Running the gambit. I know the show is about to start, so I'm going to let you get to it.
Yes.
But thank you so much and enjoy the
show.
Thank
you, my love.
Bye. Jimmie Allen, you just sang America the Beautiful to open up Night 2 of WrestleMania 39 at SoFi Stadium. How you feeling?
Well, now that it's over, now I'm nervous. I wasn't nervous before, but it's crazy. It's a lifelong dream for me. Been a wrestling fan forever, and to be here, you know, amongst the wrestling family is cool to say I'm a part of it now.
Yeah, I saw you got to meet The Undertaker, who you said you were a huge fan of as a kid.
Yeah, I actually was at the match when he fought Yokozuna in the casket match. I was there. As a kid, it was, so like all these memories kept coming back, and it's cool to be here. It's cool to see everybody, you know, hanging out, having a good time, and enjoying the entertainment that they bring to people.
Yeah. Is there a match you're looking forward to seeing tonight?
No, definitely. I'm a little sad I missed, Seth freaking Rollins last night.
It was a good one.
And Bloodline missed him last night. But we got Roman Reigns tonight, so it's gonna be good. I'm looking forward to tonight.
Yeah. And then I heard you talking about how you might want to get in the ring one day.
Oh, yeah.
Who would you face? Who would your dream opponent be?
My dream opponent? I want to lose, so I want to be a bad guy. So I want to make an introduction, kind of like I would be a bad guy. I got a name and everything. The name's Nightingale. It's a sweet name, whatever. But I would work with The Miz for a little bit to help him cheat. And then
everyone works with The Miz when they first start.
Slowly get in the ring, and I don't know. I don't know who I want to fight. I would think I would try to get them to bring an old school guy back to whoop my butt. But I definitely want to lose. I want to make it look like I'm going to win, but lose. I want to be fast. I'm talking a minute and a half.
You said you wanted them to bring back Tatanka.
Oh, yeah. Listen, I'm a Tatanka fan. You bring back Tatanka, whoever you want to bring back. You bring back Bushwhackers. I even text Bret Hart, see what he's up to. Shawn Michaels. Hey, y'all want to make a comeback real quick?
I mean, Shawn Michaels is training at the WWE Performance Center. So you said you're moving to Florida soon. That could happen.
It can happen. I'm looking forward to it. So, yeah, it's cool times we're here hanging out, you know. Yeah, I still can't believe I just sang at WrestleMania. Inside, I'm, like, losing my mind right now. Yeah. But on the outside, my inner nightingale comes out and keep it cool.
You are playing it very cool. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
And I'm going to let you enjoy the show.
I will do. Thank you.
I'm here with Francia Raisa and Lily Singh on night two of WrestleMania. Now, you guys came last night as well, which means that you are hardcore WWE fans. What was your favorite match or moment of last night?
Oh, man. I mean, I love the Uso match. That was great. But also, the females are such powerhouses. It was incredible to watch Trish and Lita, Charlotte. I mean, it was a great, great first night.
I mean, you're friends with Trish Stratus, so.
Yes. So I was going to say, so Trish and I are both judges on Canada's Got Talent, shout outs. And so it was amazing because I sit beside her at the judge's desk and I see like the mom side of her and the sweet side. And then to see her back in action in the ring, I was like, oh, snap. Because even when we're shooting Canada's Got Talent, if our call time is like 8 a.m, Trish will get up at 5, 6 to work out. So I knew she was going to hold it down and she did not disappoint.
Could you see yourself getting in the ring? I know Francia has talked about getting in the ring one day, but can you see yourself getting in the ring?
So here's the thing, right, is my intentions would say yes, but Francia does yoga, Pilates, she really works out. Me, I know I could not last probably, like, I probably wouldn't even make it into the ring. Yeah. You know when people just go over the ropes like it's nothing? Yeah. I'm like, I would be tripping and falling right there.
But you can walk down with me and like be my,
totally.
Yeah, be my so, hype man.
No, KSI was like in the prime bottle. Yeah, yeah. I could do that. Okay. Okay. I could be the mascot probably.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. What kind of mascot uniform would you wear?
Unicorn? Probably a unicorn.
Yeah, I can see that.
Yeah, I see myself as a unicorn probably.
Yeah, yeah. And I need that unicorn spirit.
Yeah, okay.
When I'm in the ring.
Okay.
You know, Kathy and I have ran the ropes before. I don't know if you know, we've taken bumps before. Like, we've been practicing.
Dang. I was going to say, how many times has Francia told you that she's taken a bump before?
You know, especially in the last 48 hours, every conversation.
It's all manifesting.
Yeah, totally, totally. But this is us. We've been friends for like quite a while now. But in the last 48 hours, we've learned so much about each other. On the ride home last night, we're just listening to WWE entrance music like the whole ride home. I'm like,
and
oh my god,
guessing,
like, these, we're this level nerds, but like I love it.
Yeah. And then there was one she put on and I said, I don't know who that is. That's, and she was like, it's Roman, your favorite. I said, that's not my man's song. I know his song. And it wasn't
different entrance. Yeah,
yeah, yeah, it was different. Yeah. But no.
I love though that you guys have actually taken trips together and the biggest bonding moment is at WrestleMania.
Yes, yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah, we went
to
Trinidad together, mm-hmm. which we traveled very well. That was good to find out.
Absolutely.
But WrestleMania was the thing.
But also, so WWE posted a story last night from the Rey Mysterio match where there was a water moment in the sister's face. And we're in the background of that shot, and me and Francia both, it's like our life ended. We were like, oh! But like in that moment, I knew. I was like, oh, we are both just
Dominic
ride or die.
That little ass beating he got with that belt. No he deserved it. El Cinto?
Yeah.
No arguments.